Okay, let us start our session, which is devoted to education session 9B. I'll be chairing this session. And let's give a floor to the first speaker, Viktor Shinkarenko, and co-authors. The title is Automated Monitoring of the Content Demand in Distance Learning. So, Viktor Ivanovich, please start.
I want to introduce you to our approach and means and software for tracking the haste focus of students, implants with the structure of information on a computer monitor. And
okay,
distant education, you see the slide, yes?
Yes.
Distant education has as benefits, you can see on the screen, and the drawbacks. And I will note their first drawback. The learning process monitoring is absent or serious difficult. Attention, interest, understanding of the material. But if it is possible to track the learning process of each student or group student, the sequence of student, we can turn our drawback to benefit. The goal of our research objectively measure what the student pay more attention to, what is ignored, how much time is spent studying this or other section of the teaching material, and so on, inside distance learning process. For our goals, we must answer to some question or sub-goals. It is possible to solve the problem using a minimal configuration of software and hardware to ensure of mass use. What software libraries can be used as base tool to solve this problem? What features of vision can be used to determine of the haze focus? How to develop a calibration and back solving process to achieve the required measurement accuracy? How to transfer from the haze focus to the observed content? For our goal, we made some experiments. This you see the conditions and restrictions of our experiments. A student look at the content on the laptop screen with one resolution and physical dimension. The built laptop video camera is located at the top of the screen and in the center horizontally. The distance between screens at the bridge of the nose is 500 millimeters. The student sits almost motionless, centered on the screen. The average distance between the pupils is taken equal to 64 millimeters. There are no significant than more 50 degrees, tent and tilts of the head, and lighting conditions are good. You see my screen?
Yes.
We use open source computer vision library. Its library made the model of the face by some landmarks, and OpenSOL can work for real time. Some landmarks determine the right and left eye. When work, our software consists from two parts. Part for a phase stage calibration, loop by calibration points and video frames processing. And stage two is education, show content and video frame processing, and the part with processing the video frames from cameras. By six landmark from the model, we calculate the center of eyes. It's here. Use median filter and change image color to gray, from grayscale to bitone. And obtain its contours by Satoshi Suzuki algorithm and convert iris contour into the circle by the Smoulens and closing disk algorithm. Here you can see the center and the pupil and center of the eyes. Here I want to show you videos by after presentation. In stage one, we do calibration on the screen, show the calibration points and registrate the distance between the eyes center and pupil center is here, and calculate or build the linear regressions for the calculate the gaze focus point from the position of pupil of gaze. And then we calculate the focus of tracking as here, coordinates and average between both for X axis and Y axis, and both of left eye and right eye, and average of this. Here you can see the example of the content, title, drawing, list, paragraph of text, software code, and so on. The information of the elements of screen stored in the JSON file, where for each item we see the position and width and height of this element. I want to introduce you for some experiments we do with a variety of calibration points, delay on the screen from 6 to 15 seconds. Calibration scheme, one of it you can see earlier, head position and position of second edition camera if it used. Here you see the accuracy of its this experiments, and you can see the accuracy for both camera average less than 10%. But you can see that 9% at this the 73 point. This is the graph of occurrence. The blue points is the points of calibration on the screen, and the red points the points of has focus on the screen. And here second graph is the sorted errors, and you can see small quality count of points has big occurrence. Main result: the approach to the development of tools for tracking the haze focus compliance with the structure of information on the computer monitor is proposed. Implemented software environment that is able to investigate the correspondence of the haze focus with the structure of information on the monitor using one or two cameras. Based on the results of the experiments, it was concluded that the errors of haze focus recognition is up to 10%. The proposed method allows for the objective management of each student's work time with one or another element of content. The lecture has the opportunity to highlight significant part that receive little attention and to supply elements that the student process for the unresolvable amount of the time. I want to show the video of work of program. You see my video now on screen?
You see something on the screen, yes.
Yes. Here you can see the calculated the purple of the eyes and center of purple. This Yulia Snigur video from Rose camera. And in real time, the calculation of the position of center of eyes. And here you can see the demonstration of calibration. The black point, the point of calibration, and red point. The point of the haze focus on screen, but no progress. No progress. And here the demonstration of the demonstration of the screen elements, but very early work my computer, and I must only some frames. No scrolling, so only some frames. You can see the scrolling of the screen and the elements for which is focus of the student. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Please, questions to the presenter. Just ask. I have a question, Viktor Ivanovich. So you demonstrated a system which detects the area on the screen on which student is focused. But how it is related with the content of the document he is looking at? Is it automized in other ways?
Yes, yes.
What information receives the teacher?
Teacher can see what time student focus for each element of content.
In which form? Is it a linear form, or it is just some numbers on the screen, or what really, so to say, see the teacher?
Now, really, teacher in JSON stored the elements, and for each element of JSON, you can see the time of student to which has focused student from the study.
Okay, and the next question, but who defines these elements? Is it again a teacher, or how the system defines on what elements they should focus?
In the now we do the JSON file by the content, not automatically. In future, we must automatically by software build the JSON file from the doc or PDF document. And there, in this document, the teacher can see the time near each element, the time what student see to this element.
Okay, let me tell, probably you know that Tesla also has a web camera to look at the driver, whether he is paid his attention on the road, and if he does not say speak on phone and so on. But for Tesla, they have fixed elements, and your task seems more complicated because you also should add elements to any documents you propose to the students. I think so, at least. Okay, maybe more questions. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Say thanks for our presenter. And we go to the second topic. The authors are Victoria Demina, Tatiana Belova, Irina Pobizhenko. Title is An Information System to Support the Process of Internal Quality Assurance of Educational Program. And that's presenter is Victoria Demina. So, is Victoria here? Or somebody? Victor Ivanovich, close your presentation. So, Victoria, we don't hear you. And don't see you.
Hello, I'm here, Demina Victoria.
Yes, it would be nice if you switch on video camera.
I don't have camera. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Dear presenter for the conference, dear participants of the conference, we present to your attention a report of the topic, an information system to support the process of internal quality assurance of educational programs. The report
is divided. Because we cannot see your presentation. Yes, now
do you see my presentation?
Yes.
Again, we present to your attention a report of the topic, an information system to support the process of internal quality assurance of educational programs. The report is divided into five parts. First, consider the meaning of the higher education program. When will we focus on the internal quality assessment of the educational program? We present internal assessment for the quality of the educational program in a mathematical model. Consider an information system to support the process of internal quality control of educational programs. When speaking about higher education, one cannot fail to notice role. Really, higher education research and inquiration play a crucial role in supporting social cohesion, economic growth, and global competitiveness. Given the desire for European societies to become increasingly knowledge-based, higher education is an essential component and social, economic, and cultural development at the same time, and increasing demand for skills and competencies, requiring higher education to respond in new ways. No process, including educational, is possible without a plan. This plan is an educational program. An educational program generally refers a system educational components within a specialty as well as the expanded learning outcomes that must they must be measured by the student. Assessing the quality of educational programs is a complex multi-iterative process that requires time and the development of large number of human resources. According to European standards, the process of quality assurance in educational has three parts: internal quality assurance, external quality assurance, and quality assurance agencies. In our country, internal quality assurance is present by the National Agency for Quality Assurance in Higher Education. In Ukrainian, it sounds like NAZIAO. Unfortunately, we have the only such agency, given university as development of choice. We will focus on internal quality assessment. It will allow the university to give advice on the question to whether the program meets the modern requirements of socially. The Intel evaluation policy should have a formal status and be public. All stakeholders of the educational process should be involved in the assessment. When developing the processing system, five groups of stakeholders were identified. As a result of the analysis, the possibilities of assessing each group of stakeholders according to the main criteria determined by the legislation were established. Assessment should have a holistic approach to identify deficiencies in the education program and improve it. The internal evaluation process is cyclical and includes the following stages: analysis of the regularity framework regarding in the assessment of educational programs, and determination of the main criteria of quality assessment, and determination of the timing of the assessment, and identification of involvement of the stakeholders of the assessment, and assurance this assessment process is carried out. Analysis of the assessment result, development as recommendation of elementary the identified deficiencies. Elimination of deficiencies with carrying out is necessary addition assessment. The system of quality criteria has its own sub-criteria and their local detailing. Their components are determined based in current regulation. Figure show an example of the decomposition of criteria 3. All details of the sub-criteria need to be assessed. For this, the following qualitative scale was chosen: A, B, E, F, and I. Grade A meets full compliance with exemplary character. B means general compliance with minor deficiencies. E means criterion is a rule is not met. F means center criterion is a wall is not meat, and the identify socialists as a fundamental nature. Next, we improved a special assessment I, which means that is impossible assess. Criteria, subcriteria, and their detailing are linked by a characterical structure. Therefore, the requirements for a quality of the educational program are presented in the form of a tree. The generated quality scores follow this structure completely. To evaluate the educational program, we have built a mathematical model and breaks down assessment into four levels. The first level assesses the detail of subcriteria, the sort in the subcriteria, the second of the criteria, and first is the final assessment. The final grade uses the grades given at the previous levels. More details about the mathematical model can be found in the article. All difficult formulas for presentation are also given there. On the basis of the developed assessment model, an information system is proposed for conducting an internal assessment of educational programs. The system contains information on stakeholders, experts involved in quality assessment providers, assessment of criteria assessing the quality of the education programs with the possibility of addition and subjecting them for the specific of a censored education program. Means for providing stakeholders with access to the documents required them on assessment structure according to the assessment tree. Support of the logical of evaluation output procedures. Identification of bottlenecks in the educational program and contradiction between the assessment of various stakeholder group. Storage of information in statistical processing of service result. The information system contains seven components of there, such as one, a database of result of detailed stakeholder subcriteria assessment, two, block of control and differential of assess right, three, database of structured documents according to subcriteria, four, assessment plan unit, five, synchronization block, six, the block for forming the assessment, and seven, block of statistical analysis of the history of assessment. The assessment process is preceded of the preparation of the documents necessary for the assessment of each level of detail. Input information for operation of the system, estimates of stakeholders at three levels. As a result of the assessment, the system can provide the following information. The final assessment of the educational program and its vector of assessment considering all stakeholders. Assessment of each of criteria and subcriteria and their details. Table for the formation of the final assessment, individual criteria and subcriteria. Vector of interim assessment of stakeholders at each level of assessment. A list leading criteria, subcriteria on which the assessment of various stakeholder group has the greatest differences. a list of criteria and subcriteria that are most critical and have had a negative impact on the overall assessment. The diagram shows the main entities of the subject area. The quality assessment table stores the result of assessing of quality of a specific criterion of a specific stakeholder. The document table stores links to document associated with the practical criteria being assessed. Table show the result of the program in the evaluation of sub-criteria 3.3. This is as a result of the operation of the system, we obtain level intimacy for the sought sub-criteria or sought criteria, E with a quantitative analog of 0.5 points. Applying this technique, we obtain intermediate evaluation, the third level, then the second. The final grade is set taking into account the necessary and sufficient condition for making a grade on the basis of grades by criteria. In this example, the final grades final score is B. The plans for research include the use of method of mathematical analysis of the estimates obtained. I share the using the logic of experts in the formation of intermediate assessments at the first, third, and second levels will be considered. We plan to conduct stakeholder analysis using cognitive maps. Work is to be done on integration system into the general information system of the university. Practical experience is that we get comprehensive internal assessment of education program quality, wherein the views of stakeholders are taken into account, any information system results subjectivity. And this is no exception. The subjectivity of assessment is reduced is a result of the application of the information system, problem areas of quality are identified. At the end of the report, let us dwell on the positive and negative aspects of the developed system. The advantages of the system include centralized storage of the information received and ability to analyze it. At the same time, it is possible to carry out partial assessment of any element. The assessment can be adapted to change in quality legislation. Any component of the evaluation tree can be modified. Moreover, it is possible to explain the tree by adding new nodes. This also applies of the depth of the evaluation tree. So the system can be used to monitor satisfaction of the education process of all stakeholders. Thank you for the attention. The report was prepared Татьяна Белова and Ирина Побеженко, as well as myself, Виктория Демина.
Thank you. Your questions, please. Then I have a question. As I understood, the advantages of your system is that you centralize the documents, and so many people have an access to such documents. How you defend your information from intruders, from people who want to change some data, maybe? Have you any system of identification, for example, of users of your system?
Talking about identification, it must be said about the problem of internal assessment. It is difficult to get exact opinion of all stakeholders. Every day worries make it difficult to get together at the same time, and the information system allow you to evaluate the education program at easy. All results are saved and they can be analyzed. The adapted educational program more closely matches the requirements of the time. That's all.
I have one maybe more small question concerning the usage of the word logic. On slide 14 and 19, you wrote the logic of assessment and the logic of the experts. Do you just say the word logic instead of some procedures or rule, or indeed you have some logical properties of assessment? In other words, what is logic of assessment? How you understand from the slide 14?
Of great interest in the question of the transition of qualitative assessment of a quantitative and vice versa. We use it binary logic to model human logic.
So you use propositional logic or Aristotle logic, because when you say binary logic, there are two cases usually, and more, of course, classical propositional and classical first order logic.
I can show you the formula.
Yes. Okay, I see that you write formulas request in logical form, yes? Well, thank you. Maybe some questions from the audience. No question. Then let us thank the presenter. And we go to the final presentation for today by Igor Chernetsky, Irina Slipukhina, Natalia Kirilenko, Sergei Minyalov, and Magdalena Apashko. The title is Application of Tracker Video Analysis for Distance Learning of Physics. and presenter is Sergei Minyaylov. Please start.
Okay. Good afternoon, dear colleagues. Now I try to show our presentation.
Okay. Yes, you can see.
Okay. Okay, let's begin. So I'd like to present you result of our research application of tracker video analysis for distance learning of physics. At first, I would have to justify the choice of our direction of research. I suppose it is obvious that study of natural sciences and study of physics, of course, is impossible without observation of different phenomena, without experiments and laboratory works. But in many cases, this causes difficult for teachers because of lack of equipment, because of the experiment can be expensive or dangerous, it can last a long time, and so on. In condition of distance learning during the pandemic, performing of real experiments in physics laboratory became impossible at all. So, as a result, our problem statement. We state that if you cannot perform experiments in real laboratory, it caused negative effect on the quality of education. And as a consequence, we state that for successful distance learning, teachers have to integrate the learning material into the virtual environment. Below you see hypothesis of our research. Yes, it is hypothesis that video analysis of real experiments is a real competitor to the corresponding models, digital models. And next. So I will allow myself a couple of words about history and about origins of video analysis. The use of video materials for scientific analysis began with the invent of photography as a technology. And you see names of founders of this direction. And I would like to pay attention on stroboscopic photography. For example, let's take photo on the left. Yes, and if we take a ruler and we draw reference frame, then we measure distances between different positions of the object, so we can make some conclusions about type of these motions. So about acceleration of the motion, and so on. It is accelerated, or maybe the contrary, acceleration is negative. We can do it in our mind. So I suppose it can be considered as some initial primitive kind of video analysis, just in our mind. But nowadays we cannot do anything without help from our digital friends. So we find this friend as a tracker, system of video file analysis. And we try to use this tracker. Так, ну, please, next file. And we have formulated our research question. Well, you know that every experiment consists of following four main stages. Like we have to take some experimental installation, conduct an experiment, take measurements, and only then we can do data processing, so we can do indirect measurement. Of course, we have three first stages we have to do in real laboratory. Так, without equipment, we cannot do this. And if we have no real laboratory, we have to transfer these three first stages into virtual environment. Так, into virtual reality. Ну, of course, this virtual reality, it can be done in three main ways. Ну,
please switch on your microphone.
Excuse me. Oh, yes, okay. Так, solution of this problem was done in three main ways. Ну, please, next. Так, ну, first way, it is just we take some software for computer simulation of real experiment. You can use some different programs, but as a rule, these programs are just some rough approximation to real experiment, to real experimental equipment. And students and pupils consider this just as some kind of PC game, some several clicks, and they get some answer, some result, and it's solved. Some other way, it is creating a video of the experiment, and then we send this video and result of measurements and equations for calculations and some instruction to students, and then we wait for answer. But in this case, we don't know that maybe students at all don't watch this video, they just use equations to calculate, to take them indirect measurements result, and then send back this result. So just some mathematical calculations, and it's all. Так, we don't know result of this video. Так, watch the video, students or not. Так, the third way is so-called m-learning, based on the use of sensitive element of measuring devices. Так, and using these elements, students can take measurements and conduct some experiments. But different student has different smartphones, and is rather complicated task to create clear instructions how to use these smartphones. So I suppose this method, it is appropriate for individual, and independent independent education of students, maybe for good students, as some additional task for the students, but it is hard to use this method in general. By the way, we have described this method in our previous article. Так, so as a result, we propose effective alternative to solving a wide range of educational difficulties. We propose some first fourth way. Так, it is based on use of video analysis using tracker. Ну, please, next. So, first of all, we have taken some survey of related research about this problem. Так, we, you see on the screen that number of scientific publications for this topic rise every year. And we have read these scientific publications. And if you look at our article, you can see a rather huge number in literature list, huge number of publications which we have read before this. So first our stage is survey of scientific publications, related scientific publications. Okay, next we formulate the purpose of our research. Analyze and generalize the practical experience of creating and using methods for scholars and students based on tracker video analysis. You see the first example on the photos of use of video tracker. For example, if we have motion of the ball thrown at some angle to horizon. Using tracker, we set second photo, we set reference frame, and then finally we can get on the right, we can get result of measurement using this tracker. Result of measurement, then of course this tracker can build some graph of dependence. Then we worked out rules for creating videos suitable for further analysis using tracker. You see this rules. It have to be good gadget, high quality gadget. Frequency of shooting. Device must be motionless and so on. We have created these rules. Then next, you see activity. Our activity aimed at the development of appropriate methods of distance learning of physics, and consisted of the following main tasks. You see these tasks on the screen. Next. Next is some example of didactic approach to application of video analysis based on tracker. Well, we take very simple experiment, classic experiment, how to find acceleration of fallen body. For this, we have taken different bodies. Well, for example, we can take metal ball, we can take some pin ball, and so on. And then we can measure, we can measure acceleration. Well, first we create video with every of the balls, and then we use the video tracker, and we can find, for example, we can find acceleration of each ball and compare this acceleration with acceleration of free fall. Well, then student have to explain. Excuse, we can continue with this slide. For example, students have to explain why acceleration is different for different balls and which acceleration is closer to acceleration of free fall. And moreover, for example, we can find is acceleration constant or not in different cases. And for example, if acceleration is not constant, students have to explain why acceleration changes. Well, it changes because force of friction can depend on velocity of motion of the ball. So you see this rather simple problem, but it can be different tasks. Okay, let's continue next file. So it's about approbation of result of our research. Approbation of our research. We write the manual instrumental digital didactics. In this manual is described methods of carrying out all the laboratory works using video. Also, we create this video, and there is some library with this video. This video is created in the STEM laboratory MANLAB of Junior Academy of Science. Then this research was approved in the summer scientific school. And you see on the screen result of survey of participants of this summer school. According to the ability to use the tracker. And you see that the majority of the participants can use this tracker. So it fits to use for students, for pupils. also так, also results of our research was approved by using in three universities. It is National Regional University, then Uzhgorod National University and Kherson State University. Так, ну, so next slide.
Sorry, that's all in my presentation, in my version of the presentation. This is all. Excuse me.
Okay, так, ну, so, and conclusions. About conclusions. Так, so. Conclusion. So, result of our work is adaptation of the software product tracker for distance and blended learning. The method of video analysis was used as a supplement to the basic educational process in physics at general secondary school and in universities. Qualitative approbation of this method was carried out, as I said, in our universities. It should be noted that performing the tasks of video analysis using tracker encouraged students to create similar videos on their own. This is confirmed by the active participation of students of Kherson State University in the competition for the best video experiment and video puzzle. This competition was a part of Science Week. Further pedagogical investigation in the context of the study are aimed at improving the methodology of physics study with achieving a creative level of application of the tools for video analysis. As a result, a student mastered the tracker algorithm should be able to make own research or use materials available in the library. So it's all. Thank you for attention.
Thank you.
But some.
Please, questions. I have a question. Let's go back to the experiment with the falling ball. Yes, you have a video tracker, but who filled the data in the table you demonstrated? Who make analysis? It is a manual analysis, or you have some software which detects elements of the experiments?
Okay, so Irina Slipukhina want to answer, or me?
It depends. On your choice.
Okay.
Analyze program is analyzing this data from experiment from the field.
Yes, but who writes this data? How they appear in the table?
Data is obtained using tracker. You see on the right. The tracker can build the graph. Tracker can give you some table with measurements. It is direct measurements, yes. And then we can analyze these measurements. Also, tracker can create equation which describe this graph.
Okay, it is external software. It is not yours, yes? It's external software. You use it simply.
Yes, it is. No, but it is free to use and everyone can use it.
Okay. And what other experiments you also analyze in such a way? Not only fallen ball, for example.
There are many experiments. And if you can find...
One minute, please. I can...
Maybe show library.
Yes. Yes. Mr. Mintani, методики. Методики.
There are many experiments in the library, because you see these experiments.
This is some example from spectroscopy.
Yes,
not mechanics. And rings of Newton rings. We have a laboratory work with optical experiments.
Brown motion.
Brown motion, yeah. This all of these laboratory works are on STEM UR science. STEM UR science, a public domain of the official website, National Center of Junior Academy of Science of Ukraine.
Okay, thank you. Please, questions, interesting talk. No, but Viktor Ivanovich, yes, please.
What novelty news in your research? Science novelty.
This is a pedagogical novelty because on a distance learning we have a problem with laboratory work with pupils and students. And this is one of approach to do that on distance learning, for example. And we haven't methodology of these works in different graduate of pupils. And we can do it. Now, after our investigation,
it's novelty in pedagogical science.
Yeah.
Pedagogy.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. More questions? I see no question. Let us thank the presenters.
Thank you.
Yes, we. Just finished in time, so thank you very much for participation. Have a nice and fruitful conference. See you, invite you to the next sessions. Goodbye to everyone.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
Goodbye, thank you.
And goodbye.